Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Zaini, and I would like to ask one question regarding about the Bible and the Quran itself. Which is, can you prove in the Bible and the Quran, which is in the Quran that says that you should say that Islam is a religion of peace. So why Allah saying that he curses the Jews itself, whereas in the Bible, it doesn't state that it curses the Arabs, for instance. So that's my question.
Brother asked a question that as compared to Quran and Bible, in the Quran, he says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curses the Jews. And in the Bible, you don't find that God Almighty is cursing the Arabs. Brother, if you analyze and read the Quran, that suppose anyone makes a mistake, it's the duty of the teacher to correct that person. And if he's at fault, that person requires a scolding. So if you read the Quran in several places gives examples of the Jews. The Jews were the chosen people. Jews were the chosen people. If you analyze in the glorious Quran, 25 prophets are mentioned by name. Majority of them, most of them, they are Jewish prophets. Jewish prophets. You will find very few which are non-Jewish. So Jews were the chosen people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, I have given you so much ni'mat, I have chosen you, yet you do not do the job. So Allah gives the answer. In Surah Muhammad, chapter 47, verse number 38, Allah says, "Wa in tatawallaw yastabdil qauman ghayrakum summa la yakun amsalukum." If you do not do the job, Allah will substitute in your place another people. Summa la yakun amsalukum, and they will not be like you. So Allah says, the Jews were the chosen people. They didn't do the job. Allah said, you go out and bring the other people. Now, the Arabs were looked down by the Jews. The Jews looked down the Arabs. These people, these ignorant people, what will they tell us something? What's the use of telling them about the religion? So Allah says, those who you look down upon, Allah makes those people to sit on your head. And the Arabs, which are ignorant people, Allah, by the revelation of the Quran, made them the torchbearers. So those who do not follow the instruction, Allah says, don't be like them. Allah says, woe to the scandalmonger. Allah doesn't only curse the Jews, Allah curses all the people who are wrong. Like for example, Surah Humazah, chapter 104, verse number 1. Woe to every kind of scandalmonger and backbiter, irrespective of whichever religion he follows. Even if he's so-called Muslim, if he backbites, Allah says, woe to them, curse them. Anyone who doesn't follow Allah's commandment, abstains and goes against Allah's commandment, Allah doesn't like them. The question is, why didn't God Almighty in the Bible curse the Arabs? Because when the Injil was being revealed, Injil is the wahi which was given to Isa alayhi salam, and Torah is the wahi which we believe, which was given to Musa alayhi salam. The present Bible is not the Torah or the Injil which we believe in. It's not an original form. But whatever form it's in, yet at that time, the Arabs were not the chosen people. When Arabs were not the chosen people, how can he curse them? How can God curse them? For example, I'm a teacher and I've taught 100 people, you know, of people living in Bombay, you know. And suppose, if you don't know subject well, how can I come and curse the Singaporeans? You are not those people who are attending my class. Similarly, Allah chooses the Jews. So when he has chosen the Jews at that time, the Arabs were not the chosen people. So the question of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cursing them doesn't arise. But otherwise in the Bible, Allah curses many other people who have done wrong. Hope that answers the question.